The great thing for me with working with JJ, it is very, very story driven. He's trying to tell a story, and those people are getting themselves in situations which obviously have to, more often than not, be created in the visual effects world. But the whole thing is very, very story driven. So in many respects, I think, although it has well over 1,000 effects in it, the first movie, it's really a backdrop to this group of people's tremendous adventure in space. Our version of the future includes a lot of things that still currently exist, because in many respects, if you travel to a city, some of those things have been around for hundreds of years, so why couldn't they be there in the future? So our kind of style, or canon as some people call it, is just that we take that very kind of relatable part of the world that you see around you today, and we build from that, and we try and make it look, we get a lot, sometimes we add a small amount and get a lot out of it. One of the earliest conversations that JJ and I had on the original movie was that in the television series, you had this idea that people were just looking at a screen as to what was going on outside. So it was kind of like they were on a set, and then through this window, you saw stuff that was happening outside. And one of the first things we did was make the view screen really big. And part of the reasoning for that was just that certainly I felt that you wanted to connect the people to space. You wanted to see what was going on outside and make them much more connected to the adventure. So if you were traveling, you got to see out the window. You weren't in a closed railway car traveling along. You were in the observation deck, and you really were connecting. And I think that made the bridge a lot more fun.